بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم، هنتكلم عن General Principles of Cancer Chemotherapy. الـ Cancer is uncontrolled cellular growth with local tissue invasion and distant metastasis. The common cancer in female is cancer breast, in male cancer prostate, and then bronchogenic carcinoma. Bronchogenic carcinoma is a major cause of this within different types of cancer. The cancer treatment option in localized tumors, a surgical intervention or radiotherapy cause or produce radical cure. But in cases such as leukemia, there is no surgical intervention except bone marrow transplantation. Many different types of cancer have metastasis, has a systemic effect, and distant metastasis to be treated, it needs cancer drugs or cancer chemotherapy drugs which destroy the cancer cells and reaching the systemic circulations. Some types of modality called immunotherapy. Immunotherapy means drugs which enhancing immunity to fight the cancer cells, and hormonal therapy and targeted molecular therapy or biological therapy. These are drugs used affect systemic circulation, reaching the systemic circulation or affecting the metastasis, but has lesser toxic effect than the cytotoxic chemotherapy. The end point in cancer research, its end point means result, events associated with the study used to assess the study treatment. Usually the end point for cancer, end point related to survival, the overall survival or progression-free survival, and end point related to response, such as the overall response and the duration of response. The overall survival means how long the patient live compared to the patient who are in control. Okay, how long the patient live. The progression-free survival, how long the persons live without the disease progression. Okay, but this is live in general, but this is live without disease progression. And so progression-free survival is an indication of the disease control, is an indication of stabilization, okay? Drug stabilization. The overall response rate or duration of response. The overall response rate is the proportion of the patient, okay, in whom the tumor is destroyed. The duration of response is time length, okay, in which in the patient which the tumor continues to respond to treatment. If at the time length, the patient responds. But this is the proportion of the patient respond to treatment, in whom a tumor is destroyed. These are an important endpoint in cancer research when reading an article related to the cancer research. A WHO classification for the response rate to chemotherapy. Number one, the complete response, complete disappearance of the tumors. Partial response means decrease of 50% or more from the original tumor. This is called partial response. And so the complete response and partial response is a good, okay, response rate. Stable disease, less than 50% response. A disease progression means 25% increase in size. This is worsening the condition, increase in the size of the tumor. When we call high response rate means complete response or partial response, plus clinical importance, clinical benefit for the patients, okay? Complete response, disappear. Partial response, 50% or more, decrease the size, okay? This is called high response rate tumors. Usually, in the cancer chemotherapy, there is a combination modality. Why there is a combination modality? Because there is existence of many different types of clones of cancer cells in most patients. Different clones of cancer cells, so failure of monotherapy, failure of one modality. So the combination is important to attack or to fight the different modality of cancer cells. A rationale, not only to fight a different modality, but also combination drugs sometimes have a synergistic effect. Sometimes we use low doses from every drug, so tolerable toxicity, effective against wide range of the cell line, as in different clones of the cancer cells, plus in the combination therapy, it decrease the incidence of resistance. Okay, this is very important phenomena or important targets in the cancer drugs to use a combination therapy. The examples of the combination modality in cancer example in the cancer breast, في early stages of cancer breast. Number one, removed surgically plus radiotherapy to fight the remaining breast tissue or to fight the lymph nodes if it's present, plus adjuvant chemotherapy or hormonal therapy for the micrometastasis. So there is a combination modality for treatment of early stages cancer breast. Another phenomenon in treatment of cancer or important definitions in the cancer drugs, the cancer chemotherapy drugs, we use a course with 3 to 4 weeks intervals. The idea, or this idea, because the cancer cell has no time to recover, but allowing the normal tissue to recover. Okay, if the course is to be with 3 to 4 weeks interval to have a time for the normal tissue to recover. But كده كده we need a monitoring for the chemotherapy, need a monitoring to monitor the normal cells which can be affected by the toxic effect of the chemotherapeutic drugs. What are the factors affecting the response of chemotherapy? The factors affecting the response, a tumor cell heterogeneity, a drug resistance, a drug intensity, drug dose intensity, patient specific factors. Very important, resistance. Resistance means decrease response with continuous administration of the drugs, usually due to decrease in activation, especially if the drug is pro-drug. Decrease in uptake of the drug by the cell. Decrease in action, apoptotic effect to kill the cancer cells. Or increase the drug inactivation and metabolism, or increase the removal of the drug by the BGP, beta glycoproteins, which is responsible for removing of the drugs, removal of the drug from our body, which is the usual cause for the multi-drug resistance. The dose intensity. There is three variables for the dose intensity. Number one, the dose per course, the interval between dose, and the total cumulative dose. Very important factor determining the response to chemotherapy. Anti-cancer drugs which kill or modify the response. It's usually used in conjugation with combination modality with surgery, radiotherapy, immunotherapy. Okay, these are different approaches for many different solid tumors. Anti-cancer drugs selectivity is limited. Okay, cancer chemotherapy is selectivity is limited, so it's toxic on the normal cells. And the latest innovation introduced a different spectrum of drugs, okay, which target the growth factor, target the signaling pathway, targeting the angiogenesis, target tumor antigens, okay. Well, these are biological factors which has killed or modify the growth of the cancer cell with lesser toxic effect. The aim of the chemotherapy. Number one, to cure, to obtain complete remission, as in cases of Hodgkin lymphoma. But sometimes we need to take an adjuvant drug. Adjuvant drugs means to mop up any residual malignant tumors, micrometastasis, after surgery. So adjuvant drugs to take the chemotherapeutics after the surgery or after the radiotherapy to move up any residual malignant cells. Palliative therapy. Palliative means to shrink the evident tumors, to decrease the size, just to alleviate the symptoms, okay? And life is prolonged in cases of ovarian tumors or non-Hodgkin lymphoma. A tumor's example for the tumor which are largely refractory to the present available drugs, the malignant melanoma or bronchogenic carcinoma are resistant tumors, and so usually the treatment is used as a palliative therapy. New adjuvant drugs are used before the surgery to shrinkage the tumor, so the tumor becomes more susceptible for the chemotherapeutic agents. Okay, the adjuvant after, but new adjuvant before the surgery. And finally, sometimes we use the chemotherapy for maintenance in a lower doses to maintain the drug, to maintain the case in a remission stage. And so the aim of the therapy either to cure, to obtain complete remissions, or to maintain the remission, or palliative to palliate or alleviate the symptoms, adjuvant or new adjuvant after, and the new adjuvant before the surgery. General toxicity of cytotoxic drugs. Cytotoxic drugs affecting mostly the rapidly multiplying cells. Most of the chemotherapy or cancer chemotherapy drugs are narrow therapeutic index. Narrow therapeutic index means any change of concentration leads to toxic effect. It's not safe drugs. As its profound effect on the rapidly multiplying cells, so it has a deleterious effect. It has a toxic effect on rapidly dividing cell. Number one of the rapidly dividing cell is the bone marrow. So bone marrow will be affected, leading to pancytopenia, anemia, and thrombocytopenia. This is a dose limiting factor, so you must decrease the dose if this is occur. Lymphoreticular system, so lymphoreticulocytopenia, the patient's liable for opportunistic infection. This leads to decrease in humoral and cellular immunity, and the patient liable for opportunistic infection with a cytotoxic drug. And so, a patient with unexplained fever and neutropenic, okay, in cancer patient, you must require prompt initiation of the empirical antibiotic therapy, okay, before full diagnosis. The oral cavity, because the patient is immunocompromised and liable for infections, okay, dental infection is common, stomatitis, irritations with stomatitis and bleeding, and xerostomia or dry mouth due to damage of the salivary gland by the cytotoxic drugs. Xerostomia leads to dental caries, and so the patient's oral cavity is liable for stomatitis, dental infection, because the patient is immunocompromised. A drug leads to damage of the salivary gland with subsequent xerostomia. Xerostomia leads to dental caries, and so this is the side effects on the oral cavity. On the GIT, damage for GIT leading to nausea and vomiting. Nausea and vomiting may be due to direct effect on the CTZ, CTZ centers, or due to stimulations of the mediatorial impulses in the upper GI, which is stimulated emesis. Okay, this is leads to nausea and vomiting. Sometimes may lead to damage of the GI mucosa and diarrhea. Other general side effects, hair bulb damage leading to alopecia. This is a reversible side effect. Germ cells effect leading to impotence or inhibition of ovulations may lead to hyperuricemia. Hyperuricemia due to destructions of the cells leading to increased filuric serum uric acid with subsequent gout and sometimes renal stones. And finally, cytotoxic effect, side effects, very important side effects of the cancer chemotherapy is drug resistance. What's meant by drug resistance? Resistance means reduction of the effectiveness of the medication. It's a major cause of the cancer treatment failure, very important cause of failure. What are the causes of the resistance? Sometimes due to expression, tumor cells express anti-apoptotic protein to preserve itself, okay, to preserve the viability of the cancer cells. Intrinsic factors or acquired factor after exposure to therapy, acquired factor due to increase for drug efflux for BGB, decrease for affinity to the drug, decrease for influx of the drug, decrease for activation of prodrug, increase for inactivation of the drug, increase for tumor cell repair. All of these leads to drug resistance. How to overcome this or minimize drug resistance? Number one, by short-term use. Okay, intensive on a short-term use with intermittent combination therapy, which is the idea in the treatment of cancer patients. The guidelines when selecting the combination therapy, number one, very important, no overlap of toxicity. Use drugs with no overlap. No two drugs have nephrotoxicity, two drugs have a bad impact on a certain organ, so no overlap in the toxicity. You usually select the drugs which has a synergistic effect. Synergistic means accentuating effect, okay, have different mechanism of actions. Use drugs with different mechanism to attack different stages of the cell cycles and to be more effective, and finally synergistic. Okay, this is a guidelines when selecting the combination drugs in treating the cancer cells. Very important points regarding the pharmacological treatment of the cancer, a tumor growth rate. Initially, the tumors have rapid growth, and then the growth decrease at the size of the tumor, because the unavailability of the nutrient to oxygen. So, radiotherapy or surgery decrease the size of the tumor, decrease the size of the tumor, and so there is adequate blood supply, and so there is more susceptibility to the chemotherapy, and so this is the role of the adjuvant chemotherapy. So sometimes the surgical intervention or radiotherapy, the idea to decrease the size, so becomes adequate blood supply for the tumor cell and becomes more susceptible to chemotherapy. The chemotherapy, sometimes not cross a blood-brain barrier, some types of the chemotherapy not crossing the blood-brain barrier, and a leukemic cell becomes unamenable for the some cytotoxic drugs, and so the better choice is to give the drug by intrathecal route of administrations or irradiations to reach the leukemic cells. Thank you.